Just that simple. If you know it's going to still raise up the fire, I see a person, I know it's hot up on the other direction.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Now, they may be thinking I don't want to have nothing to do with it, but yeah. I know the fire in me is still there.
Right.
Only one who can forget is God. Because God says, I throw all your sins into the sea of forgetfulness. You don't have the ability to forget. You have the ability to forgive. And the reason why you can't forget is because you're human and fleshly. And guess what it does? It teaches you to have wisdom that if that same thing happened to you, you've got the experience already, then not allow it to happen again. Because you're not forgetting the first time it happened to you. Amen. If somebody keeps stealing your VCR or your computer out your room, you don't have to keep it in there no more. Come on. That teaches you wisdom. That's why God is the only one who can forgive. Amen. But you've got to forgive in order to be forgiven. So a lot of that stuff is going to teach you and mature you in wisdom and love. But if you're only doing it because you want to get back at them, you're wrong. Because guess what? Even in that, if they need something, if you're a true Christian, you still provide it. Hello.
Feel it.
Amen. Amen. All right, where did we leave off here? It's what you do to others. You project behavior. Let me go back up again because that sounded out of context. The harm and danger and even destruction comes when we don't control our anger, but our anger controls us. It's what we do to others. Your projected behavior, or what is done to you inside, repressed behavior, when you get angry, that determines whether or not the anger is controlling you, or destroying or harming you inside. Because it's going to be coming from the inside. Now we're going to talk about what it does inside of you. Amen? Sometimes anger feelings come. Let me start all over again. Sometimes anger feelings can become so intense inside that the devil may suggest to you that getting high will release your angry feelings. Amen. The devil will speak to you and tell you, go get high. I came home a lot of times just to start an argument so I can go out and get high. I just got paid, pocket full. I know I need to give it up to the family. I don't want to. So I come in there, what? What are you hollering at me for? See, I can't even come to the house, I'm going. I'm going to go get high. Because my intent and my heart was I'm going home and made a plan to start a fight so I can have an excuse to get angry and go get high. Oh, look at y'all smiling at me because all y'all did it before, right?
Amen. Go home.
Amen. Yes, sis, go ahead. Hold on, please, I can't hear. What I did when I got ready to come home? Baby, I'm sorry. Can I come in? Or I broke my back door, kicked in the window, snuck in the house, and dared to come in there. Amen. That's what it is. See? I'm being real. Then hope she didn't hear me. But most of the time she did. Because guess what? She can smell me. I've been out 3 days and three nights. He in here somewhere. Anyway, let's keep reading. All right. The problem with behaviors such as getting high, drunk, or overeating is that you are trading seats on the Titanic. You will move from being controlled by one negative emotional chemical to another chemical whose power to control you is even greater. Isn't there a better way to deal with your anger? Amen. Because you know, anger brings up a chemical. Now, we're going to talk about that. A better way to handle your anger, right? The Apostle Paul, in a letter to the church of Ephesus, gave this advice to the church members. Be angry, but sin not, and let not the sun go down upon your wrath. In this text, Paul recognizes that there are two ways to handle anger. One way is to express it inappropriately. That is to commit a hurtful or harmful act. The result of being angry, sin. That's when sin comes in. Another way to handle anger inappropriately is to suppress it and go to bed feeling wrath or anger. In the first instance of an inappropriate handling of anger, we may explode, erupt, break things, scream, fight. fight, hurt someone, hurt ourselves, or destroy property. I used to watch guys, man, I never understood this, and I still don't understand it to this day. They would get so angry, they would cut themselves. They wouldn't cut nobody. They would just cut themselves. Y'all met people like that? Just take a razor and cut themselves. Because they, y'all, man, I've been doing this for years. Nobody ever knew a guy or a woman who did that. Just cut me. That self-destruction. Catfish used to do that?
No, he
did. Oh, maybe. That's demonic. That's demonic. In the second instance of going to sleep angry, we are hurting ourselves. Now here's the big one. This is what I do. Alright? Our internal system. We are hurting our internal system when we go to sleep angry. Anger suppressed or buried in the subconscious automatically explodes inside and floods your body with destructive chemicals, which wear out certain organs and systems. Repressed anger, from that scale from 7 to 10, is like sitting in a parked car, engine running, gear in neutral, and your foot pressing the accelerator to the floor. That's what it's like. Yeah. Got you, didn't it? Come on now. Would that activity harm your automobile? Repressed anger harms your body in the same way. That's why a lot of our brothers are in prison. They dealt with it and held it and dealt with it and held it and dealt with it and held it. Next thing you know, that volcano hit, boom! They killed somebody. I'm talking about real type of relationships and stuff. They go, I need one brother in prison from killing someone over stupid stuff. Because they held it in and boom, repressed. Amen? All right, what was that here? All right, any additional heat. And, let me go back up here again. I hate when I do that because I lose my way. Another problem with repressed anger is that you become like a steam kettle inside. Any additional heat may cause it to surface at a later day and be projected at a time that could be inappropriate or unto someone for whom the anger was never intended. You ever take out the anger on somebody that your man or woman caused on you? Or just go to work and take it out on your coworkers? Or wake up around here and take it out on a guy that had nothing to do with you? He in the bathroom just happy and you come in, bam, get out of my way! I ain't do nothing to you. Now you're gonna cause him to get angry. He ain't did nothing. You don't even know what's wrong with you. Hello. An example of a case demonstrating this type of projection is when a person is mistreated on the job, doesn't get a raise, etc., but doesn't address the issue at work, but buries that anger for fear of losing his job. He's just buried. He may later explode and hurt innocent people. In a similar case, another person might go to a bar after work and drink or do drugs. Someone else would also take it out on the driver in the front of their car. How do y'all get angry driving? Will you move that car? Man, I don't know about these fools. Mr. Steele, calm down. Mr. Steele, they just dropped. I didn't mess with him. Or start an argument at home with the wife or kids. This is projecting anger inappropriately. Just take it out on the wife and kids when they're doing your job. They used to call it going postal. You remember that time years ago? Every time we turned around, off in the city, postmen were shooting everybody on their job, man. They were just going to work, stressed, bam, boom, boom. Get fired, come back, I'm gonna kill them. Bam, boom, boom. That's ridiculous. That's ridiculous. All right, controlling your anger, ready? We almost fine. Got another page and a half, then we're gonna get into some more scripture, and we're gonna get into our scripture replacement thought. Who got the sheets?
Amen.
Amen, good. All right, controlling your anger. What then is the proper and correct way to handle and control anger? Well, that's what this lesson in the ABCD process of REST is intended to teach you. How to successfully handle and control your anger. Here's the nature of anger. How do you notice that when you get angry, you get a nasty taste in your mouth? Two hours studying this week, I kept saying, now I know I smoke. I brush every day. But I just had this nasty, just awful taste. I still got it. And I know it was because of stress and anger that had been rising up in me all. Dealing job and dealing with a person, it's just, ooh, what is that? So I was like, you know, you never can smell your own breath? Man, you know it's bad when you smell it. You know, it's just terrible. But I knew it's the chemicals in my body rising up. Because it creates that stuff. Amen? All emotions, anger is an emotion, and all emotions are chemicals. One of the uses of chemicals in the body is to carry messages throughout the body. Negative emotions such as anger carry negative messages throughout your body. These negative messages are stored away somewhere in your body when you suppress them. They increase the chances for heart problems, high blood pressure, stroke, and many other illnesses, including chronic conditions such as migraine headaches. Amen. One famous scientist believes that repressed anger is related to cancer. I didn't know that. These negative chemicals cause that nasty taste in your mouth by causing other nasty things to happen in your body. Everybody has heard of someone killing somebody else in a fit of anger by projecting it or expressing it in a violent act. When you continuously repress anger in your body, you are slowly killing yourself. Amen. Are you a strange man?
Yeah.
Nobody's sleeping on me.
You got one.
Amen. Go ahead. You want to say something? Okay. But nobody's sleeping with it. Because do you know our condition that we're in here? We're here because we're angry people. Not in here really angry. You need to admit it. You ain't going to get through it until you admit it. Well, I ain't angry with nobody. Huh? How many in here are angry? Amen. I know every man's hand needs to go up in here. Because if you're a man, you don't like your condition in here. And if you say you do, you're a liar. Now, are you angry with me? I just called you a liar. But you need to look at this as a stepping stone to your destiny and your success. Because you could be out there doing worse. This is a blessing. Believe it or not. And I know there's a few brothers in here who are taking advantage of their time here and getting blessed. Amen?
Amen.
They decided they're going to be angry no more. Amen. Amen. Let's keep reading. They increase the chance of heart attack. One famous scientist believes this, right? Everybody has heard of someone killing someone. We read that. All right, remember, the Apostle Paul wrote, don't let the sun go down on your wrath or your anger. Don't repress your anger and go to sleep. When you go to sleep, your subconscious mind has to store your anger somewhere in the body. Paul says, when you do this, you give place to the devil or evil, or you make your room for evil in your body. Oh, Jesus. Mm-hmm. We used to hang around with guys who would drink, and we used to call it getting the rain. They were cool till they hit that alcohol. Pop! They were ready to fight. For no reason. You can punch, beat the heck out of them. They still coming at you because they feel nothing. But they got the rams.
Man, who you been? What? You going to fight?
For nothing. We called it getting the rams. And before we would go out and game on, we would always buy a bunch of wine. Thank God I always spit up because I could never drink. But it was called getting hot. You know, building up our heart. We would get some heart and we go in the other neighborhood and we would beat them down. Too drunk to fight. By the time we finished the wine, we weren't even moving. Half the time anyway. Amen. All right. Stored anger is having evil or the devil living inside you. Repressed anger is like a poisonous snake hid inside your flesh. It has the power to strike quickly or slowly poison your life. Amen. Come on, one more little verse and we'll get back into some scriptures. Amen. What should I do with my anger? If I should not project my anger unto others nor repress it because it will eventually kill me, what do I do with the anger? Good question. You don't have to project or repress your anger. You can replace it. Hello? Your angry thoughts can be traced, erased, replaced with life-giving healing thoughts, and with life-giving healing spiritual thoughts. SRTs. The key is to identify your self-destructive thought, S.D.T, that creates your anger. You can do it in several ways. The first way is the ABCD equation method. Next, you can use your imagination to recall a picture or an incident when you became angry. You know what I used to remember? To be honest, I'm so glad they put that back in mind. I remember when my daughter was born. You know, Bruce was out back then and all that, and I wasn't born again yet, but I remember I was the first person she saw, because my wife back then had an abscess, serious section. She was knocked out, and I just grabbed my baby and raised her. Behold, the only thing greater than yourself. Didn't know I'd be born again in chance. But I would reflect on that to replace my anger. Amen. Because I finally had something of me that would last even if I died. But it also didn't help too, because you know why? I knew if I did die, I still had a piece of me. But if I had allowed myself to stay in drug addiction and die, she wouldn't have me. Hello. If I allowed myself to stay in that condition, what's the use in having a piece of you here and you're still killing yourself? Because you can't influence her to be greater than you. Behold, the only thing greater than yourself. Because she sees you as great until she recognizes who Jesus is. Amen? Amen. But that's why God gave that child to you to raise it. He trusted you and made you responsible. Amen. That's why I said, no matter what your kids or whatever's going on, you need to still love them, no matter how angry they are with you, no matter how, you know, hateful they are towards you. I still love you, baby. I ain't gonna never stop loving you. You ain't got to call. You ain't got to say hello. But every time I see you get a chance, I'm gonna let you know. Amen. Matter of fact, Shayna, baby, I love you. Shayna. Amen. All right. Once you recall a picture or the anger begins to decease, you can recall a great picture of the incident, you have at least two options. Spiritual techniques to change the anger picture that you imagine by either doing this, adding something spiritual to your anger picture inside your head, or changing your anger picture or belief system by taking something evil away from it. Your faith counselor, now that's what they call them in rap. You know, in 12 step program, they call it a bunch of sponsors. Now who's your faith counselor here? Right now I am. Who's your faith counselor during the day? Ron is. Who's your faith counselor during the night? Your roomie, your bunkmate, your brother that you're studying the word with. See, it don't have to be somebody with a title. Because if you're a Christian, you got one already. Called brother and sister. Amen. That's the greatest title you're ever going to have in Christianity is brother and sister. But if you got that attitude, and pretty soon down the line, we're going to be studying about prejudice.
I ain't talking to that white boy.
You got the wrong attitude.
I ain't talking to that black guy.
You got the wrong attitude. And call yourself Christian. But if I cut you, what color you bleed? Red. If we was in war somewhere, the Vietnam did one thing, brought us together in that area. Amen. We stood side by side. You wasn't no cracker no more, you wasn't no nigga no more. We were brothers in arms, Jack, because that Asian did not care what color you were. He was cutting you because you had an American uniform on. He gonna blow your brains out. Same thing with the Middle East. They don't care. We don't get no special right because we're dark skinned. They're cutting our heads off over there too. Hello. That's why we're all Americans. I don't know why, boy, maybe I need to say that. I am an American, dude. I am not. You see this? I'm not from Africa. I don't even refer to me as an African American. Let's see, I heard some people feel it, but I don't care. I'm not an African American. I can't even trace my roots to Africa. When my uncles and them did, we went as far as England. I was born and raised in America. When you even go to Africa, they laugh at you.
They don't even
respect you.
They don't even want to be around.
That's why I can't understand why all these churches are running over there building churches and asking me to give my money to give to it. Yeah, I said they don't want to build here in Montgomery. They want to take the money to Africa. They want to take the money to Haiti. They want to take the money everywhere to build their own communities. We're walking around Montgomery, got empty malls, vacant property, all this stuff, but they say, get us, then we'll go help them. The Bible says, take care of home first.
Amen.
Then go to all the other ends of the earth. But if you ain't taking care of home, he must be taking care of you. And Clayton was doing that. Y'all don't. Amen. I'm gonna get in trouble for that. But it's the truth anyhow. And it makes me angry. But I ain't gonna sit on it. I'm gonna tell the truth about it. Hello. Don't give your money to somebody talking about, I need money for Haiti. Every time there's an earthquake somewhere, we need money to go help. Amen. Give me a break. Why don't you hear these people that are in Montgomery say, we need money to help? Rosado wants to build some work to help people in Montgomery. But they want to give it to other countries. I don't understand that. And they got more faith over there than we do. They believe just for clean water. And yet those four, they're sending us false drugs in packages, counterfeit, you know, in the dollar stores. You think you buy the real thing, they're poisoning you. Every time you buy an aspirin, a headache pill, or some type of medicine, and you're buying counterfeit. They done made it so well to the packages are so great in counterfeit that even a pill, they have to take a microscope to tell it's phony. But you're running in those stores paying for stuff that could possibly kill you and your kids because you think you're paying for it cheaply. And not even only that, even the big companies are saying they sell them counterfeit ingredients to make the legitimate stuff. Don't buy, and I don't know why this on me, but don't buy that stuff out of those stores. Amen? Dollar General. Can you tell me why it's a Dollar General? Because it's counterfeit. Go to the legitimate places. They're poisoning us, people. The biggest drug addiction in America today, amen. The biggest drug addiction today is pharmaceutical prescription drugs. It ain't even the people who are drinking alcohol, smoking crack, shooting heroin. There's more Americans today are hooked on prescription drugs, killing themselves. And you know why? They won't even admit it. They can't admit it because they think the doctor, who they look at as God, is right. And all he's doing is throwing his pocket. Amen.
Sir, I have something to say. Yeah. I'm going to be honest with y'all, so don't think they want
it. It's a place to be honest. Come on.
Okay. You know the new marijuana they got in the Ray track now?
Uh-huh.
So like that. I'm going to be honest. I tried it the other day. Okay, I tried it.
Right? Okay.
It ain't real. It's something wrong with
it. It ain't real.
It's something wrong with that.
It ain't real.
Something wrong with it.
Stop buying this stuff, people. You give it to your kids. Stop. 60 Minutes did a big thing on it. Stop it. If it ain't from a doctor, when you ain't going to Rite Aid, maybe you need to get your stuff, watch your stuff at Rite Aid, Walgreens, all that stuff. Have y'all noticed? I don't know why I'm on this right now, because I guess I'm a little angry about it. Have y'all noticed that CVS's and Rite Aid's are on every corner around here?
Yeah.
They already started doing that in Philadelphia. Do you know why? Just so they can get the alcohol license. Now, right now, they sell beer and wine down here, which is amazing. They ain't
breathing.
Well, they're trying to get the alcohol. But it's been strategically planned years ago to put it in the neighborhoods so that they can get you strung out on alcohol and drugs. Do you see that when you go to the suburbs?
No.
You see it in the inner city. Amen. Let's finish reading.
Thank you.
I'm becoming too political, right? Because it's making me angry that they're killing our kids.
Yeah.
And we're allowing them to do it.
S-R-T. Amen.
All right, let's finish out some scripture. I really ate up a lot of time. Did I have any more on this? No, let's just finish out with some scriptures. Amen. Y'all pray for me, because I would really like to get somewhere and start talking about it. Let's go back to Ephesians chapter 4 and run through some scriptures real quick. Ephesians 4. Amen. I'm just going to tell y'all to read your scripture replacement thoughts on anger, because we did more of a study than I expected to do. I got to obey Pastor Madonna, but let's run through these scriptures real quick. 4:31 says, let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with what? All malice. So you got to get rid of it. Amen. Go to the book in front of it, Colossians chapter 3, verse 8. Beware lest any man spoil you with what? Philosophy and vain deceit. Am I up 3? No, let's read